Hi everyone. In this video, we are going to learn a very interesting construct in Python, which has something to do with repetitions. So think about repetitions in our daily life. We do a lot of repetitions. What I want to say is to do a bigger task, we actually repeat smaller tasks again and again. Consider the idea of walking, process of walking. How do you walk? You keep your left foot forward, then right foot forward, left foot forward, right foot forward. That's walking. Take some other example. You are standing on a metro station. You see first metro coming, stopping, going. Second metro comes, stops, go. Third metro comes, stops, go. When you are not feeling like sleepy, you count sheep in your mind. Sheep 1, sheep 2, sheep 3, sheep 4. Again, some repetitions happening. Your mom making chapati. So making a chapati is again a repetition of some well-defined steps. Whenever we talk about programming, it is nothing but automating the things which we do in our daily life. So programming languages should also have a way of dealing with repetitions. And that's what I'm going to talk in this video. So for discussing every construct, we are going to take a small example and try to understand it with the help of example. Here, let's take the example of a candy vending machine. So how do you build a candy vending machine? So I have a machine which, let's start with a very simple machine, and then with time we'll modify this machine and make it a full-fledged machine which can do a lot of things. So as of now, we are starting with a very basic dumb candy vending machine which has a lot of candies inside it, and there is a button. As soon as you press the button, the machine spits out 10 candies. That's all, right? You press the button and it gives you 10 candies. Every time it gives you a candy, it has a screen which displays you that a candy is dispensed. So how do I go about it? So I press the button. Then the machine starts saying, collect your candy, collect your candy, collect your candy, and it's going to say 10 times. So assuming that the machine does not give you all the candies at once, it happens one at a time. So it takes the machine some time to process, to take one candy and then give it to you. Take another candy, give it to you. And every time it gives you a candy, it says, collect your candy. How do we write a code for that? It's actually pretty simple. So the machine gives you first candy. It's going to say, collect your candy. The machine gives you second candy. It's going to say, collect your candy. Third candy, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, tenth. Right? And then I run this code. And this machine is too quick. It gives me candy. Seems like it has just processed one candy in 1 millisecond, right? I want to make my machine take some time. So what I'm saying is it might not be that fast. So assume that my machine takes 2 seconds to process one candy. I'm trying to make this code more realistic here. So the machine gives me one candy. In giving me second candy, it takes some time. What I want is I see first print statement, then I should pause for some time before printing the second statement, then I should pause for some time before printing the third statement. And it also helps me realize how Python prints statements one by one. Right. For that, I'm going to use a library here, which is the time library, and it's something actually very straightforward. So I'm going to import this library, which is called time. And I'm going to use a function from this library, which is sleep function. So I use time.sleep too. It will make my machine, my code sleep for 2 seconds. And I'm assuming these are those 2 seconds which my machine is taking to collect the candy and give it to me. So what I'm going to do, after every print statement, I'll have this time.sleep too. Now, execute this code again. So you see it waits for 2 seconds and gives you another candy, gives you the third candy, gives you the fourth candy, so on and so forth. Okay, next. Assume that along with collect your candy, I also want the machine to tell me how many candies it has given me. So when it gives me first candy, it says number of candies dispensed, one. Or maybe collect your candy number one, collect your candy number two, so on and so forth. If I want to do that, I can actually hard code it and make it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Seems like, now you see, I'm doing a lot of repetitions here, lot of copy pasting and lot of manual task. So soon we will see how we can get rid of this manual task. Before that, let's try to make this code all the more realistic. When I run this code, we will see here, collect your candy one, collect your candy two, so on and so forth. Okay. Next, what I want to do is, what if the machine was giving me 1,000 candies? Right. So the screen size of my machine is limited. So if it goes on like this, and assume that instead of 10, I wanted 100 candies, the machine won't have that much of a screen. So it makes sense that the machine should only print one number here telling me how many candies have been dispensed. Right. So the machine here should say number of candies dispensed is 1. And then instead of going in the next line, that 1 should change to 2. Then the 2 should change to 3, so on and so forth. So how do we make a change for that? So what I want here is, after this 1, first of all, next time I should not see again collect your candy, and this 1 should change to 2. How do we do that? Looks like it is something quite complicated. It is not. We can use some escape sequences to do that. So first of all, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to remove all these things from here. And let's see what will be the change, because I do not want this statement collect your candy again and again. I'm deleting it from all the lines. Okay. Next, when I execute this code. Okay. Let's collect your candy 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and it will go on. But what I want now is, this 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 should not come separately. So this 1 should change to 2, 2 should change to 3, 3 should change to 4, so on and so forth. So first of all, I do not want to go to the next line. I want to print in the same line, that too after overwriting 1. So I'm going to use here a parameter in the print statement, which is and equals to this. What this parameter will do, so by default, when I don't write it, its value is backslash n. That is, if you have two print statements in your code with no and parameter here, the second statement will come by default in the next line. If I don't want my second statement in the next line, I want it to be merged with the first line, then I can use this and equals to. And I can give here anything. So whatever I give here, that will become the end. You can write a hash, at the rate, percent, any character here. So since I haven't written any character here, so this 2 is now appended with 1. Now I want this 1 to go away, and this 2 should come at the place of 1. So what I'll do in order to achieve that, I'm going to use this escape sequence backslash b, which is for backspace. So what happened? What will happen after this 1 is printed, right? It sleeps for 2 seconds, and then this backslash b will actually rub that 1, and 2 will come at the place of that 1. Let's run it. So although 2 is coming at the place of 1, I was unable to see 1. So there is a reason for that. Right now, I'm not jumping in that reason. If you want to find out what is the exact reason, refer to the description of the video. So I'm going to use a parameter here, flush equals to true. So just to brief you about the reason, why is it happening? So Python has a buffer to show you these output, and the buffer is actually emptied when it sees a backslash n. Before that, it's not emptied. So when you only have a next line, it gets empty. So here I am actually emptying that buffer forcefully by using flush equals true. Okay, now see, when I run this code, collect your candy 1, and you see now that 1 is changed to 2, right? And then it will be changed to 3, so on and so forth. So I'm going to do this with each of these statements here. I'm going to use AND equals to this, and then flush equals to true here also, right? Because after these two, what should happen? 3 should come, and exactly the same statement for 3. I'm going to make it a 3 now. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, and then we change it. This is actually 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And let's execute it again. So you can see every time the machine is saying collect your candy, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so on and so forth. But yes, a small problem. So every time this character is actually moving forward, although it's using backspace, but it is printing one character forward. So let's resolve that. So to resolve that, I simply need to use true backslash b here. And then you run this code. And you can see here, I got my code working. So it says collect your candy, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And instead of making saying collect your candies, I can actually say number of candies dispensed. So here the machine tells you how many candies you have it has dispensed. And it will keep changing with time. Now, coming to the repetition part. So I have this machine ready, which is dispensing me 10 candies. But as of now, I have a problem with it. So the first problem is, you see, I have written such a big code. And what if I wanted 100 candies? I have to write these print statements 100 times. What if these were 1,000 candies? I have to write these statements 1,000 times. Doesn't make sense. It will take a lot of time. Second problem with this approach is, what if this number of candies which we wanted was to be taken as an input from the user? What if I have the machine first asks the user how many candies you want, and then it has to dispense that many candies? I can't use such a code there. How will you use such a code there? It will become difficult. So one way to do that is, let's say the user, one way to do that is actually using your if else statements in a very complicated way. So if the user says that I want 0 candies, you should actually not do anything. So you can have something like, let's say num candies equals to input, and the machine asks the user, how many candies do you want? Num candies equals to 0, I actually do nothing, and you can sort of show that in Python with the help of this statement, which is called pass. And then if num of candies equals to 1, then you write only one statement from here. If num of candies equals to 2, you write two statements from here. Becomes very complicated, right? So if num of candies equals to 1, you say print number of candies dispensed is 1, and you are done, right? And you'll need a else if here. Else if, and then you say else if num of candies equals to 2. So first of all, you want to implement this thing, right? So this is for my first candy, and then this is for my second candy. Then you need else if number of candies is 3, else if number of candies 4, and you keep doing that, and your code will become a hell like code, very difficult to understand. It will become very complicated, So we have an alternate way to do that, right? So let's do it for our previous example. So I'm removing all of this from here. Currently, I'm not taking any inputs also. So this is my number of candies dispensed equals to, or maybe a colon here. Okay. Now, what we want to do is we are repeating this entire thing actually 10 times. We are repeating this entire thing 10 times. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to use a loop here. That loop is called for loop. For loop means I'm going to repeat something. So let me actually show that first to you. So see, what I'm going to do here is first let me write the statement and then we'll understand what it is doing. For I in range 1 to 11, print I, right? Let's look at this simple code, what it will do. So I think you might have guessed by now. So there is this variable called I. It is going from 1 to 11. This is the range for this variable, right? And every time we are printing I. See what is happening? So these are the values of I. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, up to 10. So some things to note with this. I will start from 1. And it will go to this number minus 1. So when you write it from the range 1 to 11, it will run from 1 to 10. If you write 1, 100, it will go from 1 to 99. Okay. Now, can we use this in our code? So we can very easily use this in our code. So what we need to do is we actually need to do nothing. So we have seen that when I write for I in range 1 to 11, I is running all the way from 1 to 10. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to shift everything inside for loop. So please take care of the indentation here. So this is an indented block. Do not forget this column here. Right now, colon here. Should be here, so I don't want this one here. I want I, and then at every step I want to make my system sleep, and then I can actually remove that. So as of now, we'll implement the backslash b part later. So as of now, what it is simply doing, it is showing me the number of candies dispensed I. Let's actually run this and see. So it's actually working, but I'm seeing this number of candies dispensed again and again. So I don't want to see this again and again. I'll just move this code outside. So I'm going to write here. Number of candies dispensed. Doesn't matter to me if it comes in the next line. So we are missing on our backslash b part. Let's have that here. Now we wanted double backslash b's. So you can see here, this is the same code, but in a slightly smarter way. So the same thing which we have done in 20 lines or 10 lines before, actually 20 lines, we are able to do that in just 5 lines with the help of this loop, which is the for loop. Next time, we'll modify this code in a slightly different way in the next video.